Hi, in this video we will learn how to import data from websites. So it is a very common scenario when we are browsing the internet and searching for a particular kind of data set. We may find the data set on some website in the form of a table and we may want to analyze that data in Excel. So suppose I was exploring different countries and I wanted to note down their unemployment rate. So I stumbled upon this Wikipedia article and I see this table in which in each country, what is the unemployment rate? This data can be seen in this table. Now I want to get this data into Excel so that I can analyze it. Now, one simple way of doing this is to select this data, copy it, go to Excel and paste it. Now you can see that although the data is pasted in the Excel sheet, there are a lot of formatting issues. And also the copy paste has been done in a very static way. That is, even if the data behind or the data on the website updates, the update will not be reflected in our Excel sheet. So now we have a new way of importing data from web pages, which allows us to import the data table in the right format, and whenever the data in the background updates, the table in our Excel also updates. Now this feature of Excel is only available in Excel 2019 and above versions, which means that if you are using Excel 2016 or older versions, you will not see the option of importing data from web pages. However, since this is an important feature, even if you are using older versions of Excel, I would suggest that you continue watching this video. So let me show you how you can import data from a web page using the import feature of Excel. I am removing this data. Now I go to Data tab and here I click on Get Data from Online Sources, from Other Sources, and select From Web here. Now this box comes up. You have to provide the URL from which the data is to be fetched. So let's copy this URL and paste it here. Click on OK. Now you can see that Excel has processed this page and it has identified these five data tables from this page. The first one is title document, and this is the preview of the data in this table. Then there is this list, and you can see on the right that this is the data table that we are interested in. Then there is data of OECD countries, which you can see that if you scroll down below, this is the other table, OECD table. Then there is table 2 and table 3, which we are not interested in. So this second table, list edit, this is the one we are interested in. And you can see the preview on the right. If you are satisfied with the way in which the data is coming, then you can straight away click on load. But if you want to do some changes to how it is being shown here, you can click on edit. This will open a Power Query window. Power Query will allow us to do some changes to the format and to this data. And even if the data in the background changes or updates, Power Query will again apply all those steps that we specify right now. And we will see the updated data in the right formatting only in our sheet. So let me show you some steps that we will apply on this table. So the first thing is this third column, which is telling us the source and the date of information. I do not want to have this column. So I select this column and click on Remove Columns. You can see that this third column has been removed and correspondingly a step has been added here, which is Remove Columns. Now in our table, the first row contains country and unemployment rate. This is actually the column header. So we can specify that first row is the header by clicking on this button. Now, if I'm interested in sorting this data, so currently this is sorted by country name alphabetically. If I want to sort this by unemployment rate, I can click on this and select sort ascending. So you can see that my data is now sorted in ascending order of unemployment rate. So although the data in the background, that is on the website, is sorted in some other way, but in my Excel sheet, it will show in this format. Lastly, you can also apply filters on it. So if I want to apply a filter that only show countries which have unemployment rate between 4 and 8%, I can go here and write is greater than or equal to 4 and less than or equal to 8. So now I only see countries which have unemployment rate between 4% and 8%. Now, if you are satisfied with all the steps and the final data that you see on your screen, you can click on close and load. And the data is now in your Excel sheet in a proper tabular format. Let me show you another example of importing data from some other site. So this is worldometers.info. Here I have opened the page for coronavirus, and here we can see country-wise data of total cases, new cases, total deaths, etc. And this is continuously updated. So every day, this data of all the countries will get updated. Now, if you want to get this table into Excel, the process is similar. You have to copy this URL, go to data, get data from web, paste the URL here. Now in the navigator, we can see all the tables from that page. Now this is the first table. And this is the second table. So you may think that on our web page, there was only one table. This web page, you can see that behind this table, there is another table for yesterday. And behind that, there is another table for 2 days ago. So those two tables are also being shown here. Since we are interested in only the table of today, so I select table 0, click on edit. Now in the Power Query window, we have to see if the data is coming in the right format. So the first thing is that we wanted data of only the countries, and we also have data of continents and the whole world. And it is very easy to remove these values because against country and against continents and the world, we have null written. So we can just filter out null from here. And only data of countries will remain here. Also, we can remove these extra columns of new cases, total deaths, etc. and just keep the column which has total cases. Now we have data of all the countries. If we want to keep only the top 20 countries, we can do that by selecting this option of keep rows and mentioning that we only want the top 20 rows, that is the top 20 countries by total cases. So here is our data. This is the data that we want in our Excel sheet. Click on close and load. So here's the data in a tabular format in our Excel sheet. Now, whenever the data is refreshed on this web page, the corresponding data will also update in our Excel sheet. However, if you want to do a manual refresh, you can do that by going to design and clicking on refresh. You can also set refresh frequency by going to connection properties And here you can tick this box and enter the time after which you want to refresh it automatically. So by default 60 is written here. This means that every 60 minutes the data will be refreshed and Excel will go and fetch the data again from that web page. Now these were the two examples that I wanted to show you of how you can get data from a web page. For the purpose of practice, I would suggest that if you want to practice how to get data from web page to an Excel sheet, you can try to get financial data or historical stock prices of companies from the site of yahoofinance.com. So you can go to finance.yahoo.com, search for your favorite company. For example, if you want to look for Apple, open this, select Apple Inc. here. And here you can go to historical data and try to get this data into Excel. So that will be a good practice assignment to try to fetch the historical prices of any company from finance.yahoo.com to your Excel sheet. That's all in this video. See you in the next one.